So, hello. Let's show the easy way to install the anti-ball drop part in your macro. Because in the first video I was still using some random tools and it was so hard to do, so as you could see in the video. And I needed to install it in a new macro myself, and I was still struggling with it, even off camera, and I was really thinking like, you know, I should make something that makes this a lot more easy to do. So I did. It's a little plastic part, the silver one you see right there. And it helps to align everything in the right place of the anti-ball drop part, that's sliding. And also makes it that it's easy to move because it's stuck on there. So you only need to hold now the hard thing is actually to hold the spring back still. That's now the hardest part. But once that's in there, it's quite easy. You hold it back and now you can just easily take this part and drop and drop it right in, and then afterwards when it slides in, you take out the knife and then you just need to use a different part to hold on the sliding part and just wiggle. Now it's actually quite tight, but so you can move the installation tool out. This one I just printed brand new, new specs, and it's a little bit tight. Maybe if you find it a little bit too tight, just take a knife and scrape it off a little bit. But at the same time, it's kind of nice when it's tight, because then you don't have to risk that when you pick up the tool that it drops off. So it's kind of a trade-off. If you want to have it like it's tight, and then you really need to have a different tool to push on it so it can slide off, or you make it a little bit more loose and it will slide off more easy. What this tool also do for you is it makes it more easy to remove it in case you won't remove it because maybe some dust is in there or something like that. Then now you only have to press with your finger the slide backwards in the through the feed neck, and then everything is aligned for the tool to get in there, and that's the reason why you may want to have them that it's grippy, and then you can just pull the thing out. Of course the spring will fly forward, but in that way, if you maybe need to maintain it, or if you install it and feel like it's still a bit stiff, it has some friction so it doesn't move the way it should, then you can just take it out. That's also something I would recommend. You just use this tool in the beginning without the spring and just check if it will move with your fingers, if it will have an easy smooth fit, and that if you press the pin, if everything works the way it should, and then afterwards install it with the spring. Make sure again if it's everything moves the way it should, that's some smooth operating system, and that's really it. And it makes it so much easier. It's I should have done it in the beginning, but now it's there. I don't think too much people have struggled already with it, but now it's so much easier to install it. It's like, why not install it on everything, every adapter? But at the same time, I only did it on the ones that pointing downwards. Also a thing to mention about anti-ball drop, it's maybe a bit of a big claim. It doesn't prevent every ball from falling. In the sense, when you shoot your magazine empty, then it will prevent that the last ball that could not be fed to the marker, that ball will not drop. It's not like when you do a tactical reload, that every paintball stays inside there. The difference is with this system in place is normally you would lose two paintballs, now you only lose one. Because I think it got to do also with how the magazines work. When you take it out, that one ball is kind of still pushed out by the spring and the door is not totally closed of your magazine, so it will, I think that's really hard to prevent that one from falling. And it was for me originally also designed to make sure that when you put on a 7-round magazine that you don't waste that the last round every magazine you used when you're shooting it empty. And that was my aim, and that is accomplished with this, so I'm happy with it. But yeah, to be fair, it's not a system that really prevents any ball from falling. So if you do tactical reloads, you still will lose one ball. So it's maybe a little bit of a big name to use, but okay, huh? It kind of describes what it should be doing, and that's why I used it. Now I will show the actually installment of it in a close-up. Okay, you can print this part in a few different designs, in the sense this uses an M3 bolt to install like the rod to use it. Yes, also they have an addition with the M4 bolt or the M5 bolt, depends on what you have laying around. And there is an addition that it's fully 3D printed. So yeah, that one will take longer, but you don't need any additional parts to finish this one. So it's up to you what you want to use. All the difference are only talking about this part. This is just the same for all of them. And this installation tool should be working for all coming anti-ball-drop designs. It works for the TMC1s, T15, TPX and the D-Max. But maybe there would be one in a later future that's maybe has a longer pin that sticks out and that may interfere with that. But it should be working with all of them with no problem. So yeah, let's take this from the beginning. Normally if you have a magazine, you need a screwdriver. I don't see it laying around, but normally use a long screwdriver so you can go inside the macwell and just go inside here and just take out the print support out of this the hole where you put the spring later. Just take something long that's small, maybe a knife would also work. And just scrape that one out until it's clear. That should be the only support you need to worry about for regarding this anti-ball drop part. Then make sure that this pin can move freely to this hole right here. That's inside of here. So it doesn't have any friction and things like that. Then make sure that the slide itself is easy to install. You may as well use this tool right now. Make sure this stage works, that it can slide in. When it slides in, make sure it can move around, that's easy to slide, then everything should be okay. If not, just use a knife and scrape a little bit of the sides or something like that. Maybe you got some issues with overhang, because it's printed this way. So this part could have a little bit of residue from the overhang. It's small enough that the printer will think at least a slice would think, oh, it doesn't need any support. But at the same time, at least with my material, it kind of has a tendency to hang. So you can just use a knife and remove that a little bit, and then you're done. The orientation of the pin itself, I think for all of them, yes, for all of them, all the designs, this pin can differ from magazine adapter to magazine adapter, but the rule is the long side of the pin always points towards your marker. The shortest side always goes to the magazine. That's the way that you know what's up and down with the pin. I hope that makes sense. It's a pin and it got a small hole inside. And so that's what I mean with it. So the longer side goes towards your marker and the smaller side goes towards your magazine. To attach this part inside of this slide, I just personally use a small paper clip. Just make sure that it doesn't stick out towards the sides of the slide, so it doesn't make any friction. Then if that part moves freely, then that part is done. You can just install it in this. You can also make sure that it's that it's easy to install this tool and remove it. Then take the smaller spring of this set. Then for the spring, I sometimes use I like this one better. With a smooth beak, I guess how you call it. It helps to point it like this, so the spring just falls in. And try to place it in the hole. Try to move it in the hole. Then I personally like to use this type of blade. It's very thin, but it's flat. You could use the one with the pointy side, that it makes it a little bit harder. The spring will tend to slip away. But what you want to do right now is just use the blade and slide press the spring. Yeah, that's the right angle. Then you just compress the spring like this, and then this is the moment that you want to use the installation tool. Then it's placed. Then you see it's flush with the rest of the surface. This is of course harder to see with an actual macro, because then it's a tall wall around it. But then you can just slide the knife out. And now, of course, normally you have a Macwell, so just use a screwdriver or something like that to press down the slide, so you don't pull the slide out, because you want to install it, not uninstall it. And that's it. Now you have installed the slide. And of course this will work with pressing of the button. And that's it. So if you want to uninstall it, then just press down the slide. Then you can take in the uninstall tool, of the anti-ball drop tool, and just pull it out. And make sure you don't lose the spring. And that's it. So this makes it a whole lot easier. So I hope you appreciate this. Sure I do. It's just a small print to make. And it makes it so much easier to install this part. It's still when you need to cut the piece of wire. Things like that. It's still really small. So maybe for some people that's too small of parts to work with, but I think it should be doable. If you use like pliers like this, they can hold it and push the spring inside, things like that. it should be doable, but it is still what makes it now so much easier. You got so much. If you not have seen the old video, then you know what I'm talking about. Try to use this plier to align everything and push that slide in. But at the same time, this plier is in the way to push it in and crazy stuff. And with this, it's so easy now. So easy. The hardest thing is now, the frustrating part is to get the spring inside. Because the spring, yeah, it wants to bounce out. It wants to bounce out of the hole where the spring needs to be in. So, still, be patient with it. But it's so much easier right now. And yeah, I hope that helps. And see you guys next time.